Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Mount Calvary. Thank you, choir. I got a beautiful choir up here, don't you think? We're going to hear something incredible this morning, and I just want to welcome you. If you don't know who I am, my name's Lane Collins, pastor here at Mount Calvary, and we bid you welcome. Thank you for being here today. And if I could call your attention before we start to the bulletin this week, of course, this is Palm Sunday. This is the day that we reflect upon the fact that Jesus made his way into Jerusalem for the very last time as he was headed to the cross. And of course, this is, after today, we're moving into Holy Week as we reflect upon what Jesus went through for you and for me on his way to the cross. And let me just call attention to a couple of things. You'll notice in your bulletin on the right side, Good Friday, there's the church here is going to be open all day on Friday from 8 in the morning until 5 in the afternoon. If you'd like to come pray at any point in time during the day, please feel free to do so. Our doors will be open and you can come. And then at 6 o'clock, we've got a very, very special service entitled Worship in the Round. We started with this last year and it was just a very stirring personal time of worship. We are going to do that again this coming Friday at 6 p.m. If you would like to be involved in that or be part of that or participate, please come at 6, and I promise you it will minister to you, okay? Of course, next Sunday, we're looking forward to Easter. We're going to begin right out here with a sunrise service at 7 o'clock, followed by a youth-sponsored breakfast right here, or back in here, rather, at 7:45. It's going to be, Shoney's doesn't have you. You remember Shoney's Buffet? You remember Shoney's? Yeah. Shoney's doesn't have anything on what we're going to have. So 7:45 back here. Of course, we'll have our opening Easter service at 8:45, Sunday school in between at 9:45, and then the second service at 11. So it's just this week is just chock full of opportunities. You plug in as you can. I want to thank this choir in advance, all the bell ringers as well, everyone who has had a part in putting today together. They have organized and planned so hard for this, and I know that we are going to be the benefactors this morning. One thing I want to mention is on the order of service here, we believe Natasha Grimsley called in this morning. She has strep throat, so obviously she's not going to be here, so we're going to pray for her in just a moment as we begin this time, and you just pray for everyone involved here this morning. Heavenly Father, we love you. Thank you for the opportunity that we have just to be together in your house here at Mount Calvary. Father, we can already feel your Holy Spirit here this morning as we have fellowshipped and talked and as we anticipate what we are about to hear. Father, I pray that you will just not touch our ears this morning, but you'll touch our hearts. And Father, as we reflect upon the fact of Jesus moving into Jerusalem for the very last time on his way to the cross, Father, that is so incredibly humbling to every single one of us to know that Jesus went to the cross and paid a debt that he did not owe because we, of course, had a debt that we could not pay. Father, you be honored today. You be glorified. And Father, we do pray for Natasha Grimsley this morning. She so badly wanted to be here, but Father, we just lift her up to you and just ask that your hand of healing would be upon her and that she would be back feeling well within a short amount of time. Father, we pray your blessings upon this choir, the bells, every person who has had a part in this, including the AV team in the back. Thank you for them. And Father, now we just sit back and Father, we just expect great things as we listen to the choir and all of those, just bring honor and glory to your name. In Jesus' name I do pray. Amen.
More than just a song, our opening hymn is a much-needed prayer for Christians. It asks Christ to take us and keep us near to him every day. This song is a reminder of what happened on the cross. The first verse tells us that if we are not near the cross, we will not be able to feel the river of life that flows from Christ's side and down Calvary to all of us. The second verse reminds us that we are all lost until we find Christ. The third talks about the cross giving us strength to carry our cross of daily burdens. And the fourth verse shows us that until our dying day, we must turn towards the cross and face Christ, for it is only then that we can see our true potential, our true value, which can only be found through Him.
Thank you.
With so many problems plaguing today's world, it's no wonder people are looking for something to heal the everyday pain and struggles. Some turn to relationships, expecting their close friends and family to settle the longings of their heart. Others turn to money, shopping, drugs, jobs. But no matter how many things we try, the things of this world just can't save us from the worry and dissatisfaction of our souls. So many people jump from thing to thing, hopelessly searching for true joy and peace for their lives. In this next hymn, we hear a triumphant cry announcing a Savior like no other. In the verses, we find a poetic reminder of Christ's death, a sacrifice that truly overcame the troubles of the world. I challenge you to think and pray about those who are still looking for salvation in the things of this world. When they look to you, will they see the way to true salvation? Will they see a lifestyle that joyfully celebrates Jesus? Or will they see a person whose faith seems to have no impact on real life? Let's put that hallelujah into our everyday lives so that others will notice the difference in our lives. And then, when they ask us where we find such joy, we can tell them about Jesus, the Savior, who always gives us a reason to sing.
Thank you. When I lived in Nashville, I had the opportunity to volunteer at a women's homeless shelter in downtown Nashville called the Hope Center. The Hope Center was basically a Christian organization for women and children that had been in and out of prison, dealt with addictions of all kinds, just been homeless, just anything you can imagine. These women could come to this shelter and they could find food, a warm bed, a warm shower, clothes, and they could even enter a recovery program and get their GED or learn job skills and trade skills. But most importantly, the women were told the story of Jesus, and they had the opportunity to hear the gospel week after week. And every week, these women were required to go to chapel. And one week, several years ago, I was introduced to this Hope Center and got to see this chapel service and how they ministered to the women. And so I began going twice a month, every other Wednesday, to lead these women in worship. And I'll never forget one Wednesday morning, our speaker was sharing with them the story of the cross. And she was telling them about what Jesus had done for them on the cross. And she brought in this large wooden cross and she passed out 3x5 note cards. And she gave this powerful message about the cross. And then she passed out these note cards and encouraged the women, those who were ready, to write on these note cards the things, the chains that were binding them, the things that were holding them captive, that they needed to let go of and come to Christ. And if they were ready, to come forward and literally hammer these note cards into this wooden cross. And I remember standing up on the platform at my keyboard, just kind of playing softly while all this was going on. And I'll never forget some of the women that came forward. You know, every week at chapel, chapel was mandatory. So you can imagine there were a lot of women who did not want to be there. And they would sit in the back row with their arms crossed and just kind of glaring at whoever was on stage. And I'll never forget that morning, some of those women were the ones that walked forward with tears streaming down their faces, ready to hammer their note cards into that wooden cross. And it was like seeing women literally walk from darkness into light. And it was such a powerful moment for me. And it still gives me chills to talk about it. And I'll never forget just the emotion and the power in that moment of seeing these women's lives changed. And I went home that afternoon, and this rarely happens. This is really one of the only songs this has ever happened with. I just was so moved by what I had seen that morning. And I went home and I sat down at the piano and I literally began playing and singing this song, Power of the Cross, as though it had already been written. It was as though God just poured it out right then and there. And the song was literally written in a matter of minutes. And it's just been amazing to see how God's used that song in people's lives. And that song went on to become the theme song for the women at the Hope Center and just kind of their life song. And it's just such an honor to get to share in that ministry with them and just to see how God uses ministry to inspire a song that's going to minister to others.
There are so many things about God that we can choose to praise. We can praise God for who He is, for how He loves us, for creating us, and so much more. Our next song chooses to praise God for all the things He has done for us. God sent His Son to die, shedding His blood to wash away the sins of the world. Now we are freed from the clutches of death itself and will sing His praises for the rest of our days. In this next song, we have a reminder of God's love and amazing faithfulness to us.
We've been learning this in the first service, so if you'd like to stand and sing this, please feel free to.
See on the hill of Calvary, my Savior bled for me. My Jesus set me free. Look at the wounds that give me life, grace flowing from His side. No greater sacrifice. What He's done, what He's done, all the glory and the honor to the Son. I'm
smoke out, the stars ablaze. Only one could breathe life into clay. Only one can quiet raging seas. Only one has power to redeem. Only one spoke out the stars ablaze. Only one could breathe life into clay. Only one can quiet raging seas. Only one has power to redeem. All the praise goes to Jesus. All the praise to Him alone. All the glory and honor forevermore. All the praise to Him alone. Could crush the curse of sin. Only one was raised to life again. Only one is King of every king. Only one is coming back for me.
So many little deaths in our lives, don't we? Some are literal deaths, like the loss of a loved one. But we also experience other griefs. Relationships end, jobs are lost. Our final anthem proclaims that Jesus has conquered all those deaths. When we gather for worship on Easter Sunday and sing Christ the Lord is risen today, we celebrate Jesus' resurrection, God's good news that life conquers death. As his disciples in the world today, we must raise our joys and triumphs high to invite others to join us in this new way of living. Pray. Lord Jesus, we walk through this holy week in remembrance of the steps you took toward the horrors of crucifixion. We also remember the times our lives have led us through footsteps of grief. But because we follow you, our steps toward the healing of broken hearts and broken bodies set us free. Praise you, risen Lord, for coming to each one who opens his heart to invite you in to live for eternity. We pray all of this in your holy and precious and powerful name. Amen.